Mary Martin, the star who inspired millions. Best known for her stage performances, she would be known for originating roles such as Peter Pan, Nellie from South Pacific, and Maria Von Trapp from The Sound of Music, as well as being in shows such as Annie Get Your Gun and a traveling production of Hello Dolly, where they traveled to Japan, London, and Vietnam.
Look at me, way up high, suddenly, here am I, I'm flying!
And hello, Mary. Peter Pan goes around the world with a popular American musical, Hello, Dolly.
Hello, Dolly was chosen by the State Department to represent our country abroad, not only because it is a great musical hit, but because its vitality and sprawling good humor are so typical of home, and yet so universal.
Tokyo, minasa no utsukushii kuni ni kite ureshii. Subarashii. Tokyo wakadimasu. Tokyo mada hatten shiteru miyako. Mada ginki ni yatteru.
For you went away from your homes in the USA and into your personal haze. But when you get back to your homes in the USA, that day will be brighter than any other day. Hello, Benny. Well, hello, Abdullah. Nice to see you.
Martin was born on December 1st, 1913 in Weatherford, Texas. Her father was a lawyer and her mother was a violin teacher. She was interested in music from a young age, picking up the violin as well as mimicking popular stars at the time, including Fanny Brice and Bing Crosby. She married her high school sweetheart at age 17. They had a child together, Larry Hagman, who went on to become a famous soap opera actor, famous for playing Major Anthony Nelson on I Dream of Jeannie, and J.R. Ewing in the primetime television soap opera Dallas. She began teaching dance in Texas at her own dance studio until one day a person burnt down the studio because they thought the dancing was sinful, according to this man who burnt down her dance studio. So, because of that, she decided she would go to Hollywood. So, she divorces her husband because she knows, as well as her parents, that she's too young to be married. So, she goes off to do her dream, leaving Larry in the hands of her mother. So, they ended up having a troublesome relationship. However, in later years, they have interviews together, and it seemed like their relationship had improved.
I didn't do this because then I wouldn't have this fantastic.
Yeah, well,
may I say, I'm very grateful, Mother. It's very kind of you.
You would.
Boy, was that the greatest mistake you ever made.
No, it wasn't. It was the nicest thing I could have ever done.
Let me ask you, Larry, do you understand your mother better now than you did when, let's say, when you were a teenager?
I think she's matured a lot since she was 17 when she had me. She really has, yes. Yeah,
not grown a lot, Larry.
Well, enough.
Another thing I wondered about. Here you are, a very successful actor, with no evidence of having been overshadowed by a mother who had achieved superstar status. How did you escape that?
Strength.
It's kind of tough to...
Strength. Just being strong and just bullying your way through.
He got larger and larger. He was a rather large baby. and then he was a rather large young man. And now he's so strong that he...
You became independent early.
Independent, very early.
Independently large.
In Hollywood, she earned the name Audition Mary for being at so many auditions. At one of these auditions, Oscar Hammerstein heard her singing, which helped launch her into Broadway stardom. In 1938, she became famous for singing the song My Heart Belongs to Daddy from Cole Porter's Broadway musical Leave It to Me. Next, she would star in the musical One Touch of Venus, a story based off of Pygmalion, where she played the statue of Venus, which came alive during the show. She would go on to play Nellie in South Pacific, and even come home with a Tony Award for Best Actress in a Musical. The role of Peter Pan was one of her greatest accomplishments. She played this role in 1954 and also got a Tony Award for Best Actress in a Broadway musical.
I'm flying. Look at me way up high, suddenly here am I, I'm flying.
Next, she would go on to originate the role of the iconic Maria Von Trapp in The Sound of Music.
Songs they have sung for a thousand years. The hills fill my heart with the sound of music. My heart wants to sing every song it hears.
Finally, she did the show I Do, I Do in 1966, which was a two-person play in which she got a nomination for Best Actress. Sadly, she passed away on November 3rd, 1990, at age 77. She will be remembered as a Broadway star who inspired the next generation to dream big and fly high.